गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11th, वेलकम यू ऑल इन क्लासरूम नोट्स बाय रेखा जैन। टुडे वी विल अगेन अंडरस्टैंड द चैप्टर रंगास मैरिज विद द हेल्प ऑफ इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस विद द आंसर्स। सो लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। व्हाट इज द नैरेटर कॉल इंडियन ज्योग्राफर्स अ फ्लॉक ऑफ शीप? आंसर इज हेयर। सिंस होशाली वॉज नॉट मैंशनड इन द मैप बाय द ब्रिटिश ऑफिसर्स, Indian geographers followed the suit. That means they followed the trend. That means they didn't mention it on the map too. Thus, they behaved like the flock of sheep. One sheep fell into the pit. Rest others also fell. This can be called the mob mentality, that is to follow others blindly. Question number 2. Which disgraceful event does the author talk about that happened at Rama Rao's house? Answer. The incident of a decade ago, when English was not so commonly used and understood, a woman laborer brought a bundle of firewood there. Rama Rao's son inquired about the payment, which was just 4 pies. Since that was a fraction of amount, he told he had no change. The poor woman, who was illiterate, could not understand that meaning of the word change. She thought she was being denied her money. So, she went away from there muttering. That means complaining in a low voice. Question number 3. Who was Ranga? Why was his homecoming a great event in the village? Ranga was the son of village accountant. He was the only one in the village to be sent to Bangalore for studies. And his homecoming was a great event in the village, as the villagers were curious to know if there was any change in Ranga after staying in the city for 6 months or not. Question number 4. What kind of boy was Ranga? Answer. Ranga was a staunch follower of tradition and culture. That means he was very much committed to tradition and culture, as he still wore the janewara, that is a sacred thread, even after staying in the city for 6 months. He was also a boy full of etiquettes and respect for others. Unlike modern boys who keep straight while doing namaskar as if there are no joints in the bodies. He also touched the feet of the narrator. He was concerned and generous too as he went to the narrator's home with a couple of oranges. His views on marriage were opposite to the narrator. He was very respectful because he paid a tribute to the narrator by naming his son after his name, as the narrator was instrumental in his marriage. Question number 5. Words, mere words. Who said this to whom and in what context? Answer. The narrator spoke these words either to the readers or to himself. And when Ranga said that, he had come to disturb the singer. So, dear student, this is the incident when Ratna was singing. Ranga came at the moment and Ratna saw his shadow and she abruptly stopped. Then he said he should move, he should leave. But he didn't move because he had been impressed by her melodious voice. At this occasion, narrator spoke these words. Question number 6. Why does the author compare himself to a he-goat and Ranga to a lion? And what does God here refer to? Answer. The whole comparison is drawn on the clues from a story in which a clever he-goat was able to scare away a lion as he was in the shelter of God. So the narrator calls himself a clever goat and Ranga a lion against whom he has hatched a plan to trap Ranga to marry Ratna, and Ratna is referred to God here. Just like the lion in the story was unable to escape the clever moves of the goat, Ranga was also enchanted towards Ratna. Question number 7. Whose face shriveled like a roasted brinjal, and what poetic device is employed by the narrator here? Answer. Ranga's face shivered like a roasted brinjal as he was enchanted towards Ratna, but simultaneously disappointed by listening to the news of her being married. and author has employed the poetic device simile here. Question number 8. What were Ranga's views on marriage and how did they change? Now see, his views on marriage were similar to the views of Kalidasa as depicted in his play Shakuntala, where two mature lovers, after falling in love with each other, marry. He wanted to marry a mature girl and of his age whom he could admire. On seeing Ratna and on listening to her melodious voice, his views towards marriage changed. Question number 9. What is the underlying meaning of a girl with milk stains on one side of the face and water drops on other side? Answer. It means that on one hand, girl is so young who can't look after herself, then how will she be able to understand a husband? That means situation will be worst. 10th question. Why did Ranga name his son Shyama? Ranga named his son Shyama to pay a tribute to the narrator, as the narrator was instrumental in his marriage. So this is all in today's video. We'll meet again. Till then, bye-bye.